So it is August 2019, and I don't sound as happy as I usually am. You know, I love communicating with the people, but we suffered a tremendous loss. One of the biggest losses, I think, that the world has ever known. And he was one of a kind. He was a tremendous friend. Just a good guy. Jeffrey Epstein is no longer with us. We lost one of the true greats, who was definitely not murdered in his jail cell. That I can assure you. And I remember Jeffrey Epstein was always fun to party with. I remember the first time I met him. It was the 90s. And he was a very wealthy guy, very charismatic guy. And I walked into a room in his house. We were at a party, and I walked into his room in the house. And he said to me, "Don't mind me. I'm just doing a prostate exam." And I looked at him and I said, "Do 14-year-old girls even have prostates?" And we both laughed, and I closed the door and went back to the orgy that I had been participating in before I went looking for the bathroom, when I realized, of course, that one of the women had offered to be a bathroom. So I went back in there and relieved myself on her, and she told me she was 18, so I believed her. So we had a great time, and that was just the first time I met the great man, Jeffrey Epstein. And we traded financial advice. We went to his private island, which, you know, was sort of out, you know, international waters, if you know what I mean. No laws, no standards, no rules. And he was just a free spirit. He was a very loving, free-spirited guy. And it was so sad to see him definitely take his own life, because he had so much to live for, you know, between his medical knowledge from the first time I met him to the wealth he was able to make for so many people. He was a one-of-a-kind guy. And he will be missed. So rest in power, Jeffrey.